This tutorial is part of our full-stack React Django DRF Channels project, DJ Chat. You can watch this tutorial and many more from our YouTube course playlist, or the whole course, including access to additional resources from our Udemy course. The Udemy course link, which provides the best price for the course, is in the video description. In the previous tutorial, we created Django models. These models were converted into tables, and they described the tables that we have now in our database. So we added some data to these tables, and now it's our task to build some sort of interface and API so that the front-end application can interact with the data that's stored in our database. If we just generalize what it is that we're building in this course, we're building a front end with React, we're building a back end API with Django, Django DRF, and we've developed a database. When building an API, it is important to add authentication to ensure that only authorized users can access certain data from the database. Django DRF provides a number of built-in authentication approaches, many of which utilizes Django's built-in authentication systems. Because Django DRF is able to utilize the built-in Django authentication services or features, it makes it a lot easier for us to actually quickly implement authentication in our endpoints. So although at the moment we're not necessarily focused in on authentication at this point, it is worth us quickly configuring a basic authentication setup so that when we start building our endpoints, which I'll describe and you'll have a better understanding if you don't know what an endpoint is in the next tutorial, makes it easy for us to quickly integrate authentication with these endpoints so we can start to simulate the idea that the user has to be logged in before they can access a resource from our API. Now, in this course, we will be developing our own authentication class, but for now, we're going to be just setting up the REST framework. So head over to DJ Chat settings. Let's go ahead and access the REST framework here, and we'll go ahead and just expand that, and we'll set up a default authentication class. So what's going to happen here is that whenever we build a endpoint, a view, which has or needs authentication, we're just going to call upon the Django's, in this case, session authentication class, and that's going to help us authenticate the user should the user be logged in, and should we need it to authenticate the user before they can then access that particular endpoint, that resource, and access that data. In more simplistic terms, in our API, we're going to be having, or there will be a need for us to access users' data. Now, we don't want it so that anyone can access anyone's user's data, so we need to authenticate the user to make sure that they are logged in, and then to make sure or to identify who they are so that we can serve them the data related to that particular user. Right, so let's go ahead and set up a default authentication class here. So we just need to add in a default authentication class. So REST framework dot authentication. And then we're going to be utilizing Django's default session authentication. So by default, when we set up Django, session authentication is the default. So that allows us to create a new user and log into the Django admin site, for example. Don't forget the white space before the colon there, and you can add a comma to make sure that it's presented in this format. And there we go. So we now have told Django DRF that anytime we try to authenticate the user in a view set in our endpoint that we're going to be building, then to utilize this method of authentication. So this is going to essentially hook in to the Django session authentication service, which is then going to authenticate the user, and we can then determine which user is trying to access the resource and then potentially serve data based upon that user or just simply allow the user access to that particular endpoint.